Hi, and welcome back to myexcelonline.com. Today, we are going to go over four tips that you may want to use inside of Microsoft Project. Those four tips will include creating predecessors, the timeline settings, auto-scheduling, and creating summary tasks. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So let's go back to the project that we used in our Introduction to Microsoft Project lesson. I am scheduling a graduation party here, and I've put some tasks down that I'm going to need to do. I'm going to need to send invitations, shop for food, shop for decorations, cook the food, decorate and set up, and then finally have my party. So the first thing I would like to talk about is what is known as a predecessor. A predecessor is a task that must be done before another task can be started. So if I'm looking here on my list, I can see two tasks right now that I can't do without doing the previous one. I can't cook food before I shop for the food, and I can't decorate and set up before I shop for the decorations. So how would I go about saying that this task on line 2 needs to come before this task on line 4? Well, it's really simple. I just go over here to the predecessor column, and I type in a 2. And that 2 refers to this task up here, shop for food. So when I click out of there, and I look at my Gantt chart, I can see this arrow has been added. So what this arrow means is that task 2 will need to be 100% complete before I can start task 4. The same thing down here for task 5. I would like to say that task 3 needs to be 100% complete before I can start task 5. And when I click out of that cell, you can see that another arrow has been created, indicating that task 3 must be fully complete before I start task 5. If I double click here, I can see all of this information for my task. If I click on this tab right here called Predecessors, I can access this field over here called Lag. And what this field over here does is it says that once I have completed the first task, is there any time I want between starting the second task? So if I were to click in here and change this to one day and say okay, you can see that a whole day has been added between the completion of the first task and the starting of the second task. And if you look over here, you can see that the predecessor column has been changed to add a day. Another option I have here is if I double click on the arrow itself, I could change the lag here as well, but I could also select a different type. You can see that I have finished to start, which is what we're working with now, that this task needs to be 100% complete before I can start the next one. But I could also do start to start, and I also want to take off the lag time and say okay. So now you can see that task 2 and task 4 both have the same start time. If I double click on that again, you can see that I have a couple other options, finish to finish and start to finish. So if I hit finish to finish, you can see that my finish times have to end at the same time. And finally, if I click on that and go to start to finish and say okay, you can see that the later task actually has to be completed before the former task starts. But the correct one for purposes of our discussion today is to double click here and go to finish to start. And this is the most typical one you will usually use. So for our next tip, I would like to go over some of the timeline settings. We have a really tight timeline here because we're only using 1 week and we're using it in the form of hours. But what if I went over here and just changed the duration of each of these to days? I know this is really unrealistic for what we're doing, but I just want to show you in case you have a project that would require many days, which is a little more realistic because most projects take days to complete and not simply hours. But as soon as I change this to days, I just want to point this out. Look over here. Do you see how my predecessors now are outlined with a dotted box? That means this schedule is not realistic. And if you look, you can tell because this task has not been moved to start when this task finishes. And same for over here. But what I want to show you with the timeline settings are a couple of things. If I double click on my timeline here, instead of my units being in days, I can change this to weeks and say OK. And when I do that, you can see that I am now looking at the week view instead of the day view. But if I were to go back and change that back to days, my timeline is falling off of my screen and it's not zooming in well enough. So what I could do is I could take this slider of where my project is ending and I can just stretch it out a little bit right here. And that way I can move my entire project into one view right here with my Gantt chart. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. For the third tip, I would like to talk about this task mode over here. Right now, these are set to manually scheduled tasks, but what I would like to do is change these all to auto-scheduled. And notice how the icon changes when I do that from the pin to this icon right here. And now look what has happened to my schedule. It still takes my predecessors into account, but it has also changed my start date to everything occurring on Monday, because my number of hours over here are actually plausible to all happen within Monday. But this task over here is going to stretch over into Tuesday because that number of hours exceeds what I have available for Monday. The auto schedule feature is really, really helpful in the event that you don't want to go back and have to manually change things around every time you make a change to your schedule. The auto scheduler over here will handle that itself. So one more thing, if I go over to project and I go to change working time and I click options at the bottom, you can see that my default start time is 8 a.m. and my default end time is 5 p.m. But I'm planning this party in my off hours. I'm not planning these during a normal work schedule. So let's say that every night I have from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. to work on this. So I'm going to say OK. And I'll say OK here. And look at my schedule. You can see that I now have 8 hours spread across Saturday to Tuesday. And my 4 hours are spread across 2 days, etc. So finally, for our fourth tip, I would like to show you what summary tasks are. So if I look over here at cook food, I know that cook food is made up of several subtasks under that. So I'm going to select this row right underneath cook food, right click, and go to insert task. And I'm going to do that 4 times. And I'm also going to change them to auto scheduled. So let's say the first task is make salad. The next task is prep burgers. The next step is prep appetizers. And the final step is make cake. So now if I highlight task 5 and keep my left mouse button down and drag down to 8, and I go up here to the task menu, and I go over to this button right here to indent, you can see that all of these tasks have now become what's known as subtasks for this task above, which is in bold now. And project has also made a guess at how long each of these are going to take. So I'm going to change all of those and say each of those things are going to take 2 hours. And up here, I'm going to say that the entire task is going to take 8 hours. Also, another thing to consider is I am the only one cooking. So each of these tasks, the one before it has to happen before I can start the next one. So I'm going to start with making a salad, but right here with prep burgers, I can't start doing that until my salad's made. So I'm going to say that step 5 is the predecessor here, step 6 is the predecessor here, and step 7 is the predecessor here. Now look over here at my Gantt chart. You can see that the entire task right here is cook food, and that should take me 8 hours. But it's also broken down to these subtasks under here. And actually, if I were to come over here and change this date to Tuesday, You can see that the day for each of those subtasks has been changed as well. And I would also like to change down here the party. Let's say that that's on Saturday. So hopefully those four tips will help you to be a more proficient user of Microsoft Project. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.